am the speaker today. I am Yong Ji Hao. I'm going to present training. In my opinion, what is training? Training is a learning experience that gives it a relatively permanent change in an individual that will improve he or she in order to sustain in the organization environment. This is the author's opinion. Training is a procedure of immediate improvement required to employee. For example, the acquisition of knowledge or skill. Another meaning is to improve performance of a current health job. This usually will change in specific knowledge, skills, attitude, and behavior. This is teacher training. I mean, running. Why training matters? Training is important. 70% training is important, and education is 30%. I'm gonna explain new hire orientation. New hire orientation is important in the organization because usually newcomer in the organization they have no adapt easily in the environment, so manager or supervisor must lead or provide training program for the newcomer so that he can perform this, they can work, perform good on their job. And next, employee satisfaction. HR manager can provide the reward system so that employee, they can satisfy the employee. If the employee is satisfied, then they can produce the work efficiently and effectively. So, but of course, HR manager must provide the training and program. They must fit the employee, because if that's not fit and the employee is, they don't want to learn, and then this is wasting time and money. So, but employee, they must learn also improvement in performance and increased productivity. In the rapidly economy changing, so new technology advance and employee come and go. And so to increase the productivity, HR manager or supervisor, after they provide the training program for the employee, so this may lead to the increased productivity of the organization. So next is self-driven. After these three, new hire orientation, employee satisfaction, and improvement in performance, as a result, employees are confident and they have self-driven. So when I give example, if the one of the employees who is held in the job finance, if he or she does not come in, so the employer must maybe appoint other employee to working in the finance or accounting working. So employee, they must have ability multitasking. Education and training is different. Education is more to general knowledge, understanding of the employee total environment, but training is more on technical knowledge and skill. But education is broad and theoretical, and training is thorough and practical. And this is my overall training program. Strategy, human resource, management orientation, organization culture. organization learning organization they have the relationship. HR and orientation are linked with human resource with strategic goal and objective and develop organization culture in order to foster flexibility and competitive advantage. And how HRM link to the organization culture? And because HRM is the head of human resource, they have to link to organization culture through the practical selection and hiring employee. So the organization culture benefit is legal compliance with human rights legislation and good grassroots recruitment and selection process and equitable access to training and development opportunity. And how HRM orientation link to the organization learning? Like I said early on, the practice of employee selection and recruitment. After HR manager have planning the selection and recruitment, they can find the best fit employee, and then the employee who are talented and knowledgeable, they can generate valuable knowledge and assumption in the organization. And in the end, they can improve the whole organization performance further. So employee is the most important asset of in the organization. And how HR manager solve problem? They can either in lower level of staff or higher decision making, such as line manager and top manager in the future of organization. In the organization learning, theory of double loop learning and generative learning is to set up organization culture. And see they link again organization culture with how the feature of knowledge share and creative atmospheres gradually. As a result, the strategy human resources management such as employee satisfaction, employee relationship and commitment will be improved as well. Last is learning organization. How HRM link to organization learning? To achieve the improvement of organization performance is to apply the learning organization into the strategic human resource management. There are five disciplines of learning organization. One is system thinking, mental models, team learning, and shared vision, personal mastery. System thinking is enable employee build or think creative idea. Then they can use that creative idea contribute in the organization. Shared vision can be HR manager, supervisor, and employee combined together. So if they combine together, the more energy they have, the more knowledge they have, they can have a concrete knowledge. So they can faster solve any problem in the organization. And personal mastery is individual vision or mission. They have their own management and knowledge. And team learning is the best one I like, because team learning is everyone, employee, come together, thinking, doing their best job. Like I study how to do assignment in teamwork, so the faster accomplish the assignment. And mental models is how you shape the idea and link to the best on the internal picture. Like if I am holding a pencil, I am writing or drawing, you don't know maybe I am drawing or writing. So employee must have a sharp idea to see the big picture. The recruitment strategy are designed for selecting the fit employee who have the nature or personality they can adapt as a member and accepting the organization culture with creativity and flexibility. So after the process training, employee may be changed the role of individual. So training could be one effective and efficient tool for the application of learning organization framework. So to sum up, my opinion is these three programs that I chose are incubator and interaction each other. So they are, so as I discussed just now, they have contributed positive on the employee and organization. So I would like to carry out the strategic human resource management orientation as the most important in the organization with the empowerment learning culture. This is the schedule discussion of HHRM orientation, differences of HHRM and HRM, and how can they contribute learning culture? Three. Workforce planning, training and development, performance management and reward system. Nowadays is increased global competition and the innovation of new technology and knowledge. So I strongly agree that every organization must have a strategy, human resource management, because they have many functions. Let me discuss HHRM orientation. HHRM orientation is linked with human resource-based strategic goal and objective. And they are a part of function, HR function, strategic partner in the formulation and implementation of the company strategy. They include many activities, recruiting, selecting, training, and rewarding personnel. If manager focus on the efficient and effective management, they can achieve the organization vision or purpose. So let's see HHRM and HRM, what is the differences? HHRM is, in my opinion, he is father, and HRM is son or daughter. It's a branch of human resource, and HHRM he has a sophisticated method to make business more good. I mean, employee can perform good performance, and so sophisticated strategy method can provide job good design. But HRM is traditional method, and HHRM is long-term objective, while HRM is short. And HHRM is more focused on internal external customer, while HRM is more focused on employee relationship. And HHRM is flexible. They have line manager, while HRM is staff specialist. And usually in HRM, many jobs that employee are division, and they are independent specialization. How can strategic human resource management orientation promote a learning culture? This is workforce planning, training and development, performance management and reward system. After that, three combined, they lead to a well-qualified and motivated employee. As a result, high performance will occur in the organization. Be saying, business will change rapidly. And HRM role is helping employees understand their role in the larger picture of the company. They build a bridge between department and manager, so every employee understand what he should do. Workforce planning. Workforce planning assess the current human resource capacity is the important one because HR manager can identify their employee based on knowledge, skill, behavior, and also ability. After that, HR manager can find the right employee to undergo a training program. If newcomer, they should more on training program, and because in order to up to speed with the process of the organization, but all employee they should time to time refresh skill, so learn some new course and assess the current human resource capacity. The benefit is they advance and develop the maintainer of competency among workers. Then they can motivate workers to perform their job properly and increase production. Second, forecasting human resource capacity. Forecasting can be main scenario planning because like HR manager, they must know currently and or future what the demand and supply for the organization. So they this can support employee in the organization goal. When they have the important information for a specific human resource capacity to management. So forecasting, they can assess the company's internal strengths and weaknesses. Analysis is the third. The analysis is to identify the number of staff. Because why we need to identify the number of staff is important for HR manager or employer. If they recruit more employees, the more the organization expands certainly. So if the employee has multitasking ability or skill, of course they can do more job, so that employer can save money. And key analysis, scope of organization, the skill and technology required. So what is the benefit? After that, transform middle work performance to human access and sustaining the heightened work motivation, expand the job opportunity and unique skill, knowledge and ability. Last one. After the three that I mentioned above, then develop human resource strategy. So after employee receive the training program, HR manager can certificate them because they already contribute a good training and development. So let's see this blue bird and yellow bird. So I think that the yellow bird should not use parachute because they have wings, man. They can fly. So this means that bird no need training, man. Next, policy and procedure need to be really communicated to employees as part of their not boarding process. Training and development enable the employee skill fresh and innovative ideas. After the received performance appraisals, this can help in mapping out the designing for training for employees. So, next, I mentioned earlier, newly employed staff, they should go under some training. But all Thai employee, they should have a refresh course. And the benefit is, employee is more confidence and good performance will totally occur in the organization. And after that, as a result, after they receive all training program, the more idea about the economy and how the business is operating in the mind of the employee. Of training and development. Number one, technology training. Technology training means computer software and hardware offered. This technology training can ensure adequate human resource for expansion into new program. So the benefit is the employee confidence is built, given a fresh or unbiased professional opinion, enable team development, management skill to handle increased workloads. Diversity training, because in a rapidly changing economy and in the organization has many different races, so the more organization have different races, they have more in under one roof, they can contribute more knowledge, and different perspective races have different perspective idea. So what trend for diversity? This can increase the participant understanding, knowledge, and awareness of different cultural attributes. Just I have learned something like a case study of the Sigarani Corridors Company Limited. This company is India company. They are on coal and mining company. They provide the internal and external training, such as basic productivity, technical, work study, training to contractor or woman, and basic computer. After their employee received the external and internal program, the performance of the company in terms of production, productivity, and sales have increased gradually. Table 1, this is the SCCL company, the budget, they invest on the employee. They spend 17.56. You see the year 2009 until 2010. And after that, table 2, the co-production of SCCL increased also from 2000 to 2010 to 302.74. And next, core productivity from 2000 to 2003, their shift drops from 1.22 tons. But even though they are declining, 2004, they continuously stood up at 2.73 tons in 2010. This is the sales performance. In the end of the 2010, they already have 6.53.484 So next is performance management and reward system. Reward system, this involves appraisal of staff input and overall performance on other jobs. Offer a reward for skill development, organization performance, emphasis teamwork, collaboration, and responsibility for performance. Employee learning culture. Number one, best reward determination on positive performance data. So, organization must promote the performance data so that employee can bring the process as fair, so that this can motivate the employee to increase their motivation to achieve the desired performance result. Number two, reward teamwork and cooperation. This is significant impact on cooperation, employee cohesiveness, and the organization bottom line. Employee understand, so they must now understand how to earn the reward. So manager should provide clearly declining how employee can earn reward so that they can become more capable of achieving performance standard. And last one, set reasonable and transparent performance standard for reward. HR manager providing the employee with a dashboard. This is in order to read their performance in real time. This is realistic expectation for reward. Pay for knowledge is mean individual skill level in education attainment or learning specific information. And skill best pay mean reward employee for acquiring new skill.
Can you explain the importance of strategic human resource planning to an organization?
Planning involves gathering information that ensure manager are able to make sound decision. So, like I give example, what is the strength of the organization and what skill that employee need, and how organization allocation their resources, and how company retain employee.
Please explain why possession of the planning skills, controlling skills, and organizing skills enables managers to contribute to the achievement of organization objective.
Planning skills enable managers to set goals and identify the best way to achieve goal. Controlling skills enable managers to ensure that everything is working to plan by establishing standard of performance and comparing them with the result. Organization skill enable manager to deploy people and other resources effectively.
How can organization develop reward system strategically?
For example, market position. Economy and market trend are rapidly changed. So if the industry have labor shortage, so organization would be forced to pay a higher wage to acquire the labor need. Therefore, the organization are finding it difficult to sustain an internal wage. This is question. Thank you very much for your participation.